こんにちは。Welcome to Learn Japanese with Masa 先生。My name is Masa and I am teaching Japanese grammar for beginners. Today in this video we will do JLPT N4 grammar preparation exam. Now let's see how many questions you can get correct. Now let's go. Now here below you will see sentences from 1 to 6 on the left side and A to F on the right side.What we're gonna do now is to connect each sentences. So you select one from 1 to 6 and connect from A to F. Now let's pause this video for a while and try to connect them all. So I will explain one by one from 1 to 6 and A to F. Number one.クレジットカードで買い物をすると、クレジットカード means credit card. 買い物をする。So must form is 買い物をします。Plain style plus と means if. So this is a conditional form. 買い物をすると、if you do a shopping,So, クレジットカードで買い物をすると means if you do shopping using credit card. Number two. 安くなくても。安い is cheap. 安くない is not cheap. でも。So, て form plus も means even if. 安くなくても。Means even if it's not cheap. Number three. アルバイトは忙しかったですが、アルバイト is part-time job. 忙しかったです is past tense of 忙しいです。It means it was busy. が means but.アルバイトは忙しかったですが、part-time job was busy, but... Number four. 子供の時は静かで、子供の時。So, 子供 means kid, child. Noun の時 means when I was something something.So, 子供の時 means when I was a kid. 静か is quiet. This is not adjective. So, 子供の時は静かで when I was child, I was quiet. And then, something something. Number five. 山田さんの家は13階で山田さんの家Yamada-san's house, 13 kai. So this kai means floor or story. 13 kai is 13th floor. Yamada-san の家は13階で Yamada-san's house is on the 13th floor. Number 6. 友達に彼女の国の言葉を友達に my friend 彼女の国の言葉 So this means words that are spoken in her language. So I something something her country's words. So we still don't know what the verb is. Let's go to the right side. A 景色が大変良かったです。景色 is scenery. 大変 is very. 良かったです is past tense. The original verb is いいです。Past tense is 良かったです。景色が大変良かったです。The scenery was very nice. B. いい経験ができました。E is good. 経験 is experience. できました。So, できます is can do something. So, this is a past tense, could do. I could do a good experience. C. あまり人と話さなかったそうです。あまり is not so. It always comes together with negative verbs. あまり人と話さなかった。So, 人と話します is to talk with someone. 話さなかった is plain form, past tense negative. 人と話さなかった。Didn't talk with people. So this そうです comes together with plain style. It means I heard that. あまり人と話さなかったそうです。I heard that I didn't talk with people that much. D. お金を使いすぎてしまいそうです。お金を使います is to use money. Stem word plus すぎます is to do something excessively. 使いすぎてしまいます is I use too much. Te form plus しまいます means you do an action but actually you don't want to do. This そうです comes together with stem word. It means,I am about to do something. お金を使いすぎてしまいそうです means I am about to use a lot of money. E. 少し教えてもらいました。少し a little bit 教えてもらいます。Te form plusもらいます is used when you receive a favor from someone. 少し教えてもらいました is someone taught me a little bit. But it means that someone did the action for me. F. かぶりやすい帽子が欲しいです。かぶりやすい。So, stem word.Plus, 安い means easy to do something. かぶります is a verb for wear a hat. かぶりやすい帽子. So this is a relative clause. かぶりやすい帽子 means a hat which is easy to wear. Something something が欲しいです means I want something something.かぶりやすい帽子が欲しいです。I want a hat which is easy to wear. Now we will connect each sentences. Number one. クレジットカードで買い物をすると So what will happen if you use credit card to do shopping? So you might use a lot of money becauseYou are using credit card. The answer is D.
お金を使いすぎてしまいそうです。
So, クレジットカードで買い物をするとお金を使いすぎてしまいそうです。
If I use credit card for shopping, I'm afraid that I would use too much money.
The answer is D. Number two. So, 安くなくても even if it's not cheap, the only one you can connect with this sentence is F.
かぶりやすい帽子が欲しいです。安くなくてもかぶりやすい帽子が欲しいです。
Even though it's not cheap, I want a hat which is easy to wear.The answer is F. Number three.
アルバイトは忙しかったですが
The part-time job was busy, but The answer is B.
いい経験ができました。アルバイトは忙しかったですが いい経験ができました。
My part-time job was busy, but I could do a good experience. So it means that I had a good experience. The answer is B.
Number 4. 子供の時は静かで
When I was a kid, I was quiet and the answer here is C.
あまり人と話さなかったそうです。子供の時は静かで、あまり人と話さなかったそうです。
When I was a kid, I was quiet and it seems like I didn't talk with people that much. The answer is C.
Number 5. 山田さんの家は13階で、
So Yamada-san's house is on the 13th floor. The answer on the right side is
景色が大変良かったです。Yamada-san の家は13階で景色が大変良かったです。
Yamada-san's house is on the 13th floor and the scenery was very good. The answer is A. Number 6.
友達に彼女の国の言葉を
Now the only answer left in the right side is E.
少し教えてもらいました。友達に彼女の国の言葉を少し教えてもらいました。
So this means my friend taught me some words which is from her country. The answer is E. Now let's do a next one.So again, let's pause the video for a while and try to connect one from left and the other from the right. Now let's go one by one. Number one,
彼に元気になってもらうために
So 元気になります is to become happy or become energetic.
So, 手本 plus もらいます means I receive a favor from someone. 元気になってもらいます
is I try to make him happy and in return he will become happy. So, that's why we use 手もらいます here. Plain style plus ために means for something, in order to do something.
彼に元気になってもらうために
In order to make him happy, in order to make him energetic. Number two.
あなたの仕事の経験について
あなたの仕事 is your work.
経験 is experience. について means
about.
あなたの仕事の経験について
About your experience in your work. Number three.
日本人の名前はいろいろあって
日本人の名前 Japanese people's name
いろいろ
means various.
あって
must form is あります So it means there is.
日本人の名前はいろいろあって
There is various Japanese people's name. Number four.
今起きたばかりなので
今起きた So 起きます is to get up. Ta form plus ばかり is just did something.
今起きたばかり means I just woke up.
And then noun plus なので means because.
今起きたばかりなので
because I just woke up. Number six.
歩きながらスマホを見ている人に歩きながら
stem word plus ながら means while doing something something.So,
歩きながらスマホを見ます。
スマホ is smartphone. We don't say スマホ。
We say スマホ見ている。見ている is te form plus います。見ている means watching. 歩きながらスマホを見ている means watching the smartphone while walking. There is 人 at the end, so this whole sentence is a relative clause. So when you translate, you will go from the back.
歩きながらスマホを見ている人に
A person who is watching the smartphone while walking. Let's go to the right side.
A. 説明してください。説明します is to explain.
Te form plus ください is please do something something.
説明してください please explain.
Number two.
覚えにくいです。
Stem word plus
にくいです
means difficult to do something. So stem word plus 安いです means easy to do something. So
にくいです
difficult to do something and
安いです
easy to do something is the opposite.
覚えます is to remember.
覚えにくいです means difficult to remember.
C. いろいろ話を聞きたいです。
いろいろ is various.
話を聞きます
is to listen to the story. STEM word plus たいです means want to do something.
いろいろ話を聞きたいです。
I want to listen to your various stories.
D. ぶつかりそうになりました。
ぶつかります is to bump into someone. STEM word plus そうになります is about to do something.
ぶつかりそうになりました。
I was about to bump into someone.
E. みんなでご飯を食べに行きました。
みんな is everyone.
ご飯を食べます is to eat meal.
So go and eat is
食べに行きます。
So 食べに行きました means I went to eat.
みんなでご飯を食べに行きました。
So we went to eat food with everyone.
F. 学校に間に合うかどうか心配です。
学校 is school.
Something に間に合います
is to be on time. Plain style plus
かどうか
is whether something something.
心配です is
I am worried.
学校に間に合うかどうか心配です。
I am worried whether I can be on time at school. Now let's connect the sentences. Number one.
彼に元気になってもらうために。
So in order to make him happy, what will you do? The answer is E.
みんなでご飯を食べに行きました。彼に元気になってもらうために、みんなでご飯を食べに行きました。
In order to make him happy, we went to eat together with everyone. The answer is E.Number two.
あなたの仕事の経験について。
So about your work, what would you like to do? The answer is C.
いろいろ話を聞きたいです。あなたの仕事の経験について、いろいろ話を聞きたいです。
Regarding your working experience, I would like to listen to various stories.The answer is C. Number three.
日本人の名前はいろいろあって。
So there is various Japanese people's names. So it is B.
覚えにくいです。日本人の名前はいろいろあって覚えにくいです。
There is various Japanese people's names. So it is difficult to remember. The answer is B. 4. 今起きたばかりなので
So you just woke up. What will happen? The answer is F.
学校に間に合うかどうか心配です。今起きたばかりなので
学校に間に合うかどうか心配です。Because I just woke up, I am worried whether I can reach the school on time. The answer is F. So sorry, number 5 I forgot to explain earlier. Number 5.
外国人でも、
so 外国人 means foreigner. Noun plus でも is even if.
外国人でも、even if you are foreigner,
わかる is to understand.
わかります。
The plain style is わかる。
Something something ような is like something.
言葉 means words or language.
外国人でもわかるような言葉で
in a language like even foreigner understand. So which one will come together with this sentence? The answer is A.
説明してください。
外国人でもわかるような言葉で説明してください。Please explain in a language like even foreigners understand. The answer is A. The last one.
歩きながらスマホを見ている人に
So what will happen if you use smartphone when you are walking? The answer is D.
ぶつかりそうになりました。歩きながらスマホを見ている人にぶつかりそうになりました。
I was about to bump into someone who is looking at the smartphone while walking. So the answer is D. So this is all for today. Thank you very much for watching. How many answers you could get correct? Please write down in the box below.If you have any questions or comments or requests, please also write down. Thank you very much. Bye bye.